Namaste to all. In this short audio, we will further see some interesting question and answers. The answers have been given by my Acharya, Swami Ram Swarup Yogacharya, and the questions have been asked by common public. The question and answers are available in the website vedmandir.com. You can have a look if you are interested. Now the question is, please tell me what happens in Samadhi. My Acharya answers, Samadhi stage is only attained by a great yogi after following Vedic path like name jap, yajna, havan and hard practice of Ashtanga Yoga. Such yogi when attains Samadhi realizes the Almighty God and experiences divine pleasure, but it is of no use if a person only knows about Samadhi by the way of words. A follow-up question on the same topic, is it true that craving for Ishwar is called Vairagya? My Acharya answers, no please, it is not true that the craving for God is Vairagya. Vairagya means when an aspirant after following the Vedic path like name jap, havan, yajna, ashtanga yoga practice has attained the stage where he denies all the comforts and materialistic articles of the world except desire of realizing Almighty God. Next question, I want to know how can I talk less and concentrate more on my work? My Acharya answers, Vedas have preached a lot about talking. Atharveda Mantra 7x113x1 and 2 and Samaveda Mantra 353 says that one should not talk unnecessary hard talk because it destroys the person. Such talk is full of poison and all gentlemen always avoid such talk. Atharveda also preaches not to talk unnecessary and says to talk always sweet in the mantra 1x34x3. And also Atharveda says to talk to the point. So we must always obey their preach of Vedas and Shastras to make life long and happy. For this purpose, one must control the 5 senses, that is eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. Atharveda Mantra 8x9x15 preaches that we must wash out all the dirtiness of the said 5 senses by its control, and this control is obtained by self-firm decision and faith on the Vedas and Shastras. What a beautiful answer. The next question, why do most of the yogis do not come to the public and spread the truth? Do you know anybody else who believe could be a true yogi? My Acharya answers, people may believe things which they see before their eyes, but actually this has no concern with the nature of a perfect yogi. In Bhagavad Gita Shloka 2x55, Sri Krishna gives answer to Arjun that when a yogi has controlled all his senses etc. and has killed his desires and has become satisfied with the source of his soul only, then his mind is stable in Almighty God. Atharveda Mantra 1x1x2, 3 and 4 mantra clarifies that if aspirant invites a yogi or a yogi asks the followers to come to him, then the yogi who is the learned of Vedas starts giving the knowledge of Vedas and yoga, otherwise not. In some other mantras of the Vedas, it is mentioned that the knowledge is only given to an aspirant who so desires. So the question is only of the aspirant who is deserving, otherwise all yogis are having polite heart. I have spent most of my time in dense jungles in Rishikesh, where in a cave Baba Bankandi Maharaji used to live. He was a yogi, but now he is not alive. No more yogi I know who have attained Samadhi, please. Next question, I am very busy and unable to do Swadhyaya. My Acharya answers, in the commentary of Yoga Shastra 2x1, Vyas Muni states that to chant the holy name of God and Yajna according to Vedas and the study of 4 Vedas and the holy books based on the Vedas which gives the salvation is called as Swadhyaya. The said method is to be adhered to by all means because God has blessed us with this human life for the same. Life is not only to study, to earn money, to enjoy. In this matter, there is no excuse, please, because Yajurveda Mantra 7x48 clearly states that human beings are free to do good or bad deeds, but result is awarded by Almighty God. Therefore, if we have no time to worship God, then accordingly, sorrows, tensions, sickness, early death and several problems arise in our life to be faced. Next question. Which mantra will bestow health, wealth and happiness? My Acharya answers, Gayatri mantra will serve the purpose, please. In my channel, I have made several videos regarding Gayatri Mantra, common misconceptions about Gayatri Mantra, meaning of Gayatri Mantra, how to do Havan with Gayatri Mantra. All these things you can find in my channel. Go to my playlist under English videos. You can find all the English videos related to Gayatri Mantra. Next question, how do we identify whether a person teaching yoga has attained samadhi or not? My Acharya answers, there is only one way to identify that a yoga teacher. First, will not take any charges for his preach. Secondly, he will be preaching Vedas along with the teaching of performing holy yajna daily with Ved mantras. He cannot be professional. Next question, nowadays, will anybody be eligible for moksha? My Acharya answers, it is fundamental law that those devotees are eligible for attaining moksha who, under the guidance of learned Acharya of Vedas and Yoga philosophy, learns Vedas, follows it, and after hard Vedic worship, first attains asceticism as per Yoga Shastra 1/15 and 1/16, and then attains salvation. The said principle is applicable at all times. Next question, can a married woman recite Lalita Sahasranamam daily without doing head bath? Are there any rules? My Acharya answers, Lalita Sahasranamam matter is not mentioned in the Vedas, please. So you may take advice from a local pandit on the said matter. This is my comment. Lalita Sahasranamam and Vishnu Sahasranamam does not tally with the Vedic knowledge. They are anti-Vedic. So you may go to the website vedmandir.com to get more information about it. My Acharya has written in detail about this. Next question, Swamiji, is it better to start your day with Gayatri Mantra? Can you specify how to start your day? My Acharya replies, yes, starting of the day with Gayatri Mantra is eternal, pious and faithful to everybody. I too start with the same from 3 o'clock in the morning and thereafter remembrance of Guru Diksha's name of Almighty God. Then yoga, pranayam, meditation and yajna, study and teaching of Vedas and yoga. Teaching of Sanskrit grammar, etc., etc., etc. I have also given details of Gayatri Mantra on the website vedmandir.com. Please study. Next question, why do great saints was suffering from cancer? The saint name is not spoken out here, but it is available in the website vedmandir.com. So my Acharya answers, once I was sitting with my Guru Maharaj in a dense jungle in his cave. Suddenly my Maharaji asked me that why the most of the present saints remains ill with so many diseases. Some are fatty, some are thin, but both are ill and they die in early ages. I replied that I do not know the reason, please. Then my Acharya told me that every saint gets money in huge quantity from the public, but they do not do tapasya. And that is why the food eaten by these saints makes them sick, giving plenty of diseases. The present saints mostly speak based on bookish knowledge only and they are far away from tapasya and yajna, ashtanga yoga practice and study of Vedas. They hide their illness by false saying that they are observing the diseases of their disciples of which there is no any scope in the Vedas. What a beautiful answer. Next question, what a birth blind sees in his dreams during the sleeping. My Acharya answers, a person who is blind since birth does not see any dreams. Wow. Next question, why should we offer 3 samidas in the fire? What is the significance of 3? My Acharya answers, when samida are offered in the fire, then the same are burnt in the fire. Fire is everywhere, so is in samida. And when samida are offered in the burning fire, then the secret fire within the samida becomes visible fire. It is a hint that in the ancient time when an aspirant used to come before a guru to take diksha, then the aspirants brought samida along with them with the idea that the aspirant is like a samida to be burnt in the fire, that is the fire of knowledge of the guru. This is the first samida for the body, the second samida is for mind and the third for soul. In addition, there are 3 gunas of the prakriti, which are the qualities of prakriti, that is rajogun, tamagun and satogun, by which the human body is made. These gunas are itself illusion. So 3 samidas are offered to burn the illusion to know the light, that is the knowledge. Beautiful answer by my Acharya. What is the meaning of the website Ved Mandir? Mahacharya replies, the meaning of Ved is eternal knowledge which emanates direct from God in the beginning of every creation. In Sanskrit, the meaning of Mandir is a pious place. So meaning of Ved Mandir is the pious place where the knowledge of Vedas is delivered. I hope you enjoyed the answers by my Acharya. I request you to listen it again and again. And also I have made several videos before this. You can go to the playlist in the YouTube channel where I have mentioned question and answers from my Acharya. You can read the or you can listen the other audios as well. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om.